Hi, everyone. I'm meteorologist Jared Heil with a video weather blog update for you. Hopefully, you've had a great work week out there. Time for the weekend. It's going to be mild. No big changes in the weather story because all the precipitation heading our way this weekend. No big snowstorms to forecast. There's a storm heading our way, but it's going to be mainly rain. As you can see here, the weather pattern is very warm. The rain goes all the way up toward the northern tier of the country. No snow until you get in the high terrain of Colorado and New Mexico, where they've seen some big snows in the ski resort area. So if you're traveling out that way, there'll be some snow for you. But low pressure system should be traveling a little more south this time of year, but this time around heading toward the north and northeast, right toward like the Quad Cities and the western lakes. And anytime you're south of that low pressure center, that means warm temperatures, and that's what's going to happen through the weekend. We'll stay mild, mainly cloudy, a few showers, but then by Sunday afternoon, as the low pressure approaches, most of the rain will exit. We'll see some sunshine. It'll become breezy, and highs will be in the 60s by our Sunday afternoon. So it's going to be a very mild weekend, more like, you know, mid-October here than mid-December. So kind of strange stuff. Look at the numbers across the country right now. Seeking out some colder temperatures or even anything close to normal, and you don't find much. It's in the 50s in portions of Iowa here at 7 o'clock their time, 8 o'clock our time on a Friday night in December. It's colder up north, but nothing too terribly extreme for those folks either. It's supposed to be cold up there, and it is, but not too terribly cold considering they're advertised or in the 20s and lower 30s. So looking forward on our forecast the next couple of weeks, well, is anything going to change? That's a big question. We're getting closer and closer to Christmas. Folks are wanting some snow around this part of the country, and you know, not a whole lot of change is expected. We look at these index values. You can just barely see the numbers here. This is a Pacific pattern. This is a North American, North Atlantic pattern. And what you need to know about these is that they've been negative and they're going to stay negative. When they're negative, well, sometimes you can get some cold weather, but really what needs to happen is this Pacific pattern needs to go positive, and this Atlantic pattern needs to stay negative for you to see sustained cold in the eastern part of the country. As you know, I'm not a big cold weather lover. A lot of folks are. My colleague Jay Cardosi is really wanting a big snowstorm. He's not too thrilled about this pattern right here because this is not an ideal recipe for snow. And once again, that's not going to change. Those blue lines there go out on our forecast, not backward. That's going forward through the end of December. So we'll see some cold weather, but not a whole lot in the way of sustained intense cold. And it's going to be warm ahead of these storm systems, so not a lot of snow to go with these things as well. So not a very good chance of a white Christmas, more of a green Christmas, it looks like, with some grass showing up in those yards instead of the white stuff. This is the current jet stream pattern. Where's the cold air? Well, out west relative to normal. That white arrow kind of moving along there, that's the jet stream flow. I've painted that on there for you. Here we are. Here's Louisville. It's warm. The oranges, the greens, that means above average, what we call height values, above average temperatures, all the way up through the depth of the atmosphere. This chart is actually at about 18,000 feet or so, but it is a big indicator of what happens down here at the ground where we are. What changes? Well, once the front passes through on Monday, we'll get a shot of cold air. Chilly day on Tuesday, highs in the 40s, but once again, average highs are in the upper 40s, so, you know, 5 to 10 degrees below normal, not too big of a deal. Warm relative to average up toward the north and east of us, and also kind of chilly again on the west coast, which means that it's going to warm back up. And you can already see the bubble of warm air over the four corners. Watch what happens. We get toward Thursday. The day is here on the left side of the screen for you. You can see another bubble of high pressure building through. This is going to be a wet day. Another big storm system is carving out the center portion of the country. But ahead of it, it's warm. So no front end snow. That's when you get your big heavy wet snows, when the moisture punches into a cold air mass. Well, when you have no cold air, you don't get any snow, obviously. So this is a rain system, even though it's going to be very cold behind it. And look at the trough digging into the west coast. This, the fact that it's offshore of the west coastline, means it's going to get cold around here and it's going to warm up out west. That's usually what that means. And in this situation, that happens. By Friday, it's very chilly around here. Once again, it's because of this guy as well. It's blocking the cold air from being where it should be. It's forced south, and also the ridge is forced west into the intermountain part of the country, just east of the west coast, and the big trough is a little farther west. So this pattern is actually a pretty good pattern for us to see cold temperatures. But notice the big ridge in this part of the country, and also notice what's happening. The jet stream is heading through Montana and then down into like Rapid City and into the middle part of the country. And when you have this air flowing over the mountains, it compresses and warms as you get into lower elevations. That's not a good recipe for keeping cold weather around here. Let me tell you, it's going to warm back up. And by Christmas Eve, well, here you go. Bubble of high pressure building in to the middle part of the country. The jet stream relaxes a little bit. It's cold off the East Coast. It's cold off the West Coast. And if we look at temperatures, you see the same thing. Cold weather is exiting. More cold out west. It's warm in the middle, and we warm up. And Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, looks like it's going to be one of those days with highs maybe in the upper 40s, mid-50s. Not too terribly active, so maybe not a whole lot of precipitation, but certainly not looking very white this go around anyway. What about after Christmas? Well, this is a long-term forecast model, a different one that we were looking at a second ago, but tells the same tale. The last week of December, kind of warm around here as that bubble of high pressure builds through. The cold air back toward the west and even the north. The greens and blues are cold. The yellows and oranges are warmer than average. Then as we shift forward another week, and now we're getting into some desperate territory here. We're getting into the new year. This is, you know, 3-4 weeks out, the four-week temperature forecast. But it does show that our transient pattern of ups and downs continues. And we see a cold shot heading down toward the northern tier. Very chilly in the northern U.S., back toward Canada. It warms up a bit in Alaska, but once again, it's cooling off here, but not too terribly cold. And if you're traveling down toward the south, really they're not getting much of an impact. It looks like more wet weather down there and just kind of cold and drier on this part of the country if this model were to actually play out. It's way too far out there to know for sure, and it will likely change, but that's the way it looks right now, and that's what we have to show you. So as we go forward in time, once again, the bottom line on all this, when are our mild periods? This weekend, then Wednesday and Thursday, and then possibly after Christmas or right around that time. Colder periods around Tuesday, quick hit and cool day. Friday and Saturday looks really chilly, like we were talking about. Maybe some snowflakes, but not a big deal. Just some snow showers off the lakes. And then by early January, it could cool off some, but I'm kind of skeptical at this point of it lasting very long. I think we may have to wait till mid-January or late January for the pattern to really flip, for colder weather. So the chances of snow, huge snow showers on Friday, next Friday I'm talking about, but no big storms on the radar as we peer into the next 10 to 15 days. Of course, Jay and I and the rest of the team are here updating this forecast daily, and as we get new information, we'll update the weather blog as needed. I'm Jared Heil. Have a great night.